We did the psychiatrist and the psychologist and the neurologist and all the different ologists. Brain Bounce was able to put their finger on it and say, this is exactly why she's struggling.
If your child is struggling, Brain Bounce works. Call 800-877-5500. There is hope.
Hi guys, I'm Alicia Darby for Westside TV's Focus on Fitness. This is my first time ever here at Oral Psych, and I can't wait.
What's very cool about Aura, we get really into the music and then also the lights. We have lights embedded all over this room here.
Now, we've heard a lot about spinning, but spin bikes can look kind of intimidating. Where to begin?
I hear it all the time. People are really intimidated to get in. First thing you want to do is, and the instructor should help you out with this too, so you can always ask the instructor for help. Let's come over to the bike. You want to get the seat right up to about your hip height. So right up at the top of your hip. All right, why don't you hop on now?
Okay.
Now this can be a little tricky.
Oh yes.
And the second thing you want to do is get clipped into the bike. A lot of spin studios will give you these special shoes, and that's another intimidating element too. The front end of the clip will go in first, slide in like that, and press down the back.
So simple.
And now you're trapped. You see, that looks perfect because she just has a slight bend in her knee right at the bottom of her pedal stroke. So she's not hyperextending her knee, and she's not putting any strain on her hip by being too low either. So guess what? You're already in your first position.
Okay, I'm spinning.
That's what it's called. First position, you're just seated, your hands are comfortably placed on the handlebars. In second position, you actually lift yourself up above the seat. And if you're taking a spin class for the first time, you might be more comfortable just staying in the seat the whole time. But in second position, you really engage your core and just lift yourself up and hover there. You want to make sure your head is really steady in the mirror. You're not going up and down too much. A little side to side is okay. You just want to make sure you're not going up and down. Third position, you walk your hands all the way out to the ends of the handlebars, and you're a little more extended when you lift up. You want to keep your hips pulled way back. You're really holding a lot of strength in your core, especially when you put that light grip into the handlebars. So you're not really working your shoulders so much. Those should be nice and relaxed. You're holding that strength in your core, and when you keep your hips pulled back, it's really lengthening and engaging your butt too.
The most important part.
Generally, you're simulating a ride outside. You're gonna go up hills where there's gonna be more resistance, and then you're gonna go down some flatter roads where you're pedaling at higher speeds.
This is a great workout. Thank you so much, Barry. I really appreciate
it. You're very welcome.
We'll see you guys next time on Focus on Fitness. I'm Alicia Darby for Westside TV.